And talking about his economic team, he had a tweet coming from Arsenio Balesaca, and I think it was earlier today when he said that it's first the State of the Nation address today, and then tomorrow they're going to have the post-SONA economic briefing where all the members of the cabinet will elaborate on the government's various plans and programs mm-hmm. in the near and medium term. I mean, talk to us about the communication strategy here, Professor Tihanki. What do you think about that? I'll elaborate with the details later. What do you think of that strategy?
Sorry, I did not get the question, Carmina.
What do you think about the current communication strategy being implemented by the Marcos administration, wherein you communicate the agenda first in general terms, and then you elaborate later on, as evidenced by the tweet from Secretary Arsenio Balbisnakan earlier when he said, it's SONA today, but the post-SONA meeting right. with the economic managers giving the details will be happening tomorrow, Professor.
Well, I think this is a part of the... part of social media seeping into official communication, government communication. This is how you do it on social media, right? You tweet it first, then you discuss the details later. So apparently, since he has become a blogger himself, no, this is part of the communication strategy. And we are seeing here the merging of his social media communication style and strategy with his official function as the communicator-in-chief.
With that strategy, do you think it has been effective? And I'm talking about him heading his own press conferences, but as well as the vlogs that he would put out.
Right.
He has done that even before the campaign and during Precisely. The campaign, and it is continuing still now.
And that has contributed to his success, to his electoral success, and that endeared him to the greater majority of the people, especially those you know, whose only source of information is social media. So he has been able to adjust and to adapt, perhaps because of his loss in the vice presidential race in 2016. He was able to tweak his strategy, and now he has fully embraced social media. And social media, he, next to President Rodrigo Duterte, he is our a social media president.
Do you think it's...
But unlike President Duterte, this guy actually uses social media.
Mm-hmm. So, and maximizes
and it. And maximizes it to his mm-hmm. benefit.
Do you think it's effective enough to convince other people who did not vote for him, who did not support him during the elections, to come on over to his side?
Well, to tell you honestly, I haven't watched any of his blogs during the campaign, but mm-hmm. after he won, I saw some of it, and I found it very effective.
Mm-hmm.
So he has learned. No? He has adapted to the technology, and it has, you know, it has helped rebrand the Marcos name. No? So here's a guy, you know, he looks so amiable, friendly, family man.
Right.
And then,
right.
and then you parade your three cute kids. Ah, there you go. So, so yeah, it's part of the rebranding. No? So, but where is the line, no, between official communication, as Casey was saying, was pointing, and social media communication.
Just parallel to that, about my question about asking people to come over to his right. side and support him. You did say that you're expecting him to hammer on his call for unity, which he had been doing during the campaign. But how important is it? Is it a priority for him to still have people opposed to him come and support him, encourage them to support him, even though he already has a majority?
But of course, in politics, popularity is fleeting. No? Mm-hmm. The heroes of today can be the heels of tomorrow, right? Mm-hmm. So we have seen that time and time again. No? So it's, as we keep on saying, it's political capital that needs to be nurtured and cultivated, and it should be invested. So you know, you can expend all your political capital, and the next day you're already the most unpopular politician in the country.